Welcome back to Velshi and Ruhle. Uber wants to cut down your commute time and take to the air. The company is pushing Uber Elevate, a program using electric vehicle takeoff vehicles that say it says will be going to be in place by 2023.
But if, like us, you live in New York City, Uber plans to launch a helicopter service less than 1 month from now, ferrying passengers from Manhattan to JFK Airport for only $200.
Now, that's just a traditional helicopter service. What we're talking about with Uber Elevate is a sort of a new vehicle, the type we haven't seen before, that can just take off horizontally like take off like a helicopter and then fly like an airplane horizontally. Joining us now is the director of engineering for Uber Elevate, Mark Moore. Mark, thanks for being with us.
Oh, my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
You're working with a bunch of different companies to develop this flying vehicle. What do you call it? You guys have a name for it. When do you actually, when are we going to see one of these? When will we actually be testing it? When do you expect it'll be certified? You're talking about having the first ones up and running by 2023?
The first certified aircraft will start. We'll get a handful in 2023, but there's already test aircraft that are flying today.
And that's one of them behind you? That's what it sort of looks like?
Yeah, you can see one of the cabins where we're pioneering this idea of aerial ride sharing so that people can share the ride and get a very affordable flight across town.
Let's talk about Ubercopter. You want to get that up and running a month from now. We, of course, are talking about the fatal helicopter crash that happened here in New York City just yesterday. There currently are helicopter services, but they're significantly more expensive than just $200 an hour. And I'm not saying that more money means more safety, but you're cutting costs in a huge way. How can you ensure people's safety, especially as we're coming off something like yesterday?
Yeah, that's a great question. So that's what this summit, Elevate Summit, is all about. It is advancing this new type of vehicle that can replace helicopters and achieve a much, much higher level of safety. So that's where these eVTOL, electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft, come in, where they don't have single components that can lead to crashes such as that. Instead, they have redundant systems where any single part can fail and the aircraft can still fly and take off and land just fine.
What do you need in terms of either infrastructure or regulation that is out of your hands? What do you need cities to do?
Well, that's where Uber is kind of the orchestra conductor, and all of our partners are coming together to do different pieces. So we kind of attracted the best in class of whether that's a vehicle partner such as Boeing or a real estate company that's building the skyports for us such as Hillwood down in Dallas. So it's all about being able to bring all these best of companies together to create this new transportation system that is going to be transformative and let us take advantage of the third dimension.
If you're allowed to do that, talk us through the regulatory roadblocks you have, because let's take Uber in its current position. A lot of people in different cities would argue the congestion Uber has caused has been debilitating and it hasn't been solved yet. I don't know that Uber is doing anything to address that. And now you're adding a whole other level.
Well, actually, we have the Uber Pool product, which is fantastic in relieving congestion. So our whole idea with Uber Elevate and this aerial ride sharing is to pool people together so less vehicles are in the air or on the ground. We've already implemented Uber Pool in many of the largest cities very, very effectively so that even three people are sharing the ride and it's one car on the road instead of three.
So have you taken away, in putting Uber Pool in place, have you taken other cars off the road?
Well, again, you have
like more
one
cars.
UberX. No, you have one UberX, which is doing carrying three different people. So it's actually less cars and a lower price because we're encouraging customers to share the ride. So we very much are a believer in helping to remove congestion through these pooled products, and that is at the heart of what we're doing. We'd never want to fly around a single person because then it would be a very, very expensive trip and a waste of resources when you can pool people together much, much more effectively and efficiently.
Hey, MSNBC fans, thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down there and click on any of the videos here to watch the latest interviews and highlights. You can get more MSNBC for free every day with our newsletters. Just visit MSNBC.com/newsletters to sign up now.